we got pretty number of mails regarding a gate question, which is again asked in BARC 2016 paper also. The answer to the question was a little bit different in different question banks. In this video, we'd like to give you the correct answer for the question. By the end of this video, you'll be having a clear idea what is the solution for this question and what is the method in which you have to solve it and what are the mistake the question banks or the particular institutes have committed. So let's read out the question. You can see on the screen. A cylindrical container of radius r is equal to 1 meter, wall thickness 1 millimeter, is filled with water up to a depth of 2 meters and suspended along its upper rim. The density of water is 1000 kg per meter cube and acceleration due to gravity is 10 meter per second square. The self weight of the cylinder is negligible. The formula for hoop stress in a thin cylinder can be used at all points along the height of the cylindrical container. If you see the screen, they have given us a vertical cylinder. A liquid is there inside the cylinder. As liquid is in static conditions, the pressure will be going on increasing along its depth. So I am redrawing the particular diagram on the board here. You can look, it's given like this. So if you take the data from the question, R is given as 1 meter. So this becomes 2 meters. And thickness is given as 1 millimeter. So I am writing down here. So T is equal to 1 millimeter. R is equal to 1 meter. So diameter is equal to 2 meter. And total height is equal to 2 meter. But in this question, they are asking us few details at mid height. You can look here on the screen. I am reading out the question. The axial and circumferential stress sigma A comma sigma C experienced by the cylindrical wall at mid depth 1 meter as shown R. So we have to get the sigma A and sigma C at mid height of the cylinder. So if you see the diagram, it's given like this. At this mid height of 1 meter, we need to get the value of circumferential stress and hoop stress. Okay. First of all, let's get the value of circumferential stress. Here, the circumferential stress will be produced due to this particular pressure. So whatever pressure is acting will be acting on the circumference. Now if you see the top view at this cross section, at this cross section of mid height, it will be like this. This pressure we can calculate P is equal to rho g h, where h is equal to 1 meter. Rho is given 10 cube kg per meter cube, g is equal to 10 meters per second square given in the question. So h is equal to 1 meter. So we'll be getting the value of pressure. Okay. Now, because of this pressure, we'll be getting circumferential stress. So if you take a small element that will be expressing circumferential stress. And you know the formula for sigma c, Pd by 2p. So if you are substituting out the values, so pressure is equal to, based upon rho gh value, so 10 cube g into 10 into 1 into diameter is 2 by 2 into plate thickness 10 power of minus 3. So this comes out to be 10 mega pascal. This is how you are going to evaluate the value of circumferential stress at the mid height. Now, according to this question, we need to get also the value of axial stress. So it's the most important one here. Now we need to get the axial stress at mid height. So let's take the cross section. At this cross section, if I am cutting It's like this. We need to get this value of axial stress. But this axial stress is actually produced by this pressure. Pressure acting at the bottom. So this pressure P is actually given by the formula rho g capital H, where H is equal to 2 meters. So 10 power of 3, 10, 2. So we'll be getting the value of pressure in this way, rho g H. We got the value of pressure. So now we have to use the formula sigma A is equal to PD by 4T. You may wonder how this formula is coming, or you may not be convinced that how this sigma A and P are related. Simple derivation here. If you see the top view, sigma A is acting on this cross-sectional area. So upward force should be downward force to keep the body in equilibrium. So you'll be getting like this. Sigma A into this area, as the thickness is very small, so I will try write down the area as 2 pi r t. That is equal to pressure into pi r square. So upward force is equal to downward force. So based upon this, you'll be getting the value of axial stress is equal to PD by 4T. So here also, if you substitute, the answer will come out to be 10 megapascal. So the answer for this question is A. You can see the screen there. So option A is given as 10 megapascal, 10 megapascal. So this is the correct answer here. In many question banks, what the mistake they committed is, they simply thought that always the axial stress will be less than the circumferential stress or half of that value. So the correct answer should be B. That's absolutely wrong. That is the reason why this question was again asked in BAR 2016 examination. And those people who have rectified those mistakes, those people only got the correct answer for the particular question. Now let's see the next question of this particular slide or particular question. I'm reading what the question. If the Young's modulus and Poisson's ratio of the container material are 100 gigapascal and 0.3 respectively, the axial strain in the cylinder wall at mid height is. So different options are given. At mid height, we need to get the axial strain. We have the formula for axial strain like this. Epsilon A is equal to sigma A by E minus mu into sigma C by E. You know the value of sigma A comma sigma C, both are equal to 10 megapascal. Mu in the question is given as 0.3 and E is equal to given as 100 gigapascal. So this all will lead to get the value of axial strain as 7 into 10 power of minus 5. You can do the calculation there. This is how you have to get the answer here. If you get the wrong answer for sigma A and sigma C as 5 megapascal and 10 megapascal, then you will be ending up according to the option number A, which is absolutely wrong. By this video, I hope everybody got the clear idea regarding how to solve this question in a correct way. So we'll be again come with another video on some other gate questions or some other topic. So kindly tune to our channel. Thank you so much, everybody.